The peer review is short, just 4 pages. It backs up the findings of the first engineering report, calling its risk evaluations reasonable. And it says remediating the highest risk roof panels with an eventual replacement of them and the entire roof are appropriate to safely extend the useful lifespan of the building. The reports examined the lighter weight concrete roofing panels, known as RAC, outdated in construction today.
The building did not close exclusively because of the RAC issue. It closed because of a multiplicity of issues.
Today, infrastructure officials raised other problems. The heating and cooling system, asbestos, and say repairs to one of the buildings across a ravine could be complex.
We cannot rehabilitate this asset unless the entire buildings are vacant. There's no spot repair that will be sufficient or safe.
The minister responsible says it's not worth fixing.
Even to bring it up to a standard and code, we're talking about $500 million in the existing facility.
But the government has already been planning to move the Science Centre to Ontario Place, part of a controversial development there.
Neither report recommended shutting down the Ontario Science Centre.
The local Liberal MPP feels the government is trying to justify its decision and gives his take on the peer review.
It reaffirms what we already knew, set the Science Centre has a roof that needs some maintenance, and that maintenance can be done, and that it's not about to collapse so long as the work gets done.
The government also released the business case from 8 years ago under the then Liberal government, also looking at the cost to fix the Science Centre, finding it cheaper to move. Already then, repairs were needed.
We invest in buildings, you know, and
the editor-in-chief of an architecture magazine says historic buildings are worth fixing.
It's heartbreaking to see such a great place being taken away from me and my kid for completely spurious reasons.
A new temporary science center is at least 2 years away from opening. Lorenda Redekop, CBC News, Toronto.